In this video, we're going to explore the original software that would have been included on a Lenovo ThinkPad T440S when it was brand new in late 2013 or early 2014. This particular machine was built in April 2014, and it has a Pro Windows 8 sticker at the bottom. Well, we're going to take a look at three options: Windows 7, Windows 8, and a slightly more updated version with Windows 8.1. Let's start with 7. I won't show the recovery process since it's very similar to the one for the ThinkPad T410, which I've done a video about. But here, there's an extra option for partitioning the drive with GPT, or GUID partition table, which does work with Windows 7 if CSM is enabled in the BIOS setup. But I'm not using the T410 disks. These disks were made for the T540, which is just a larger version of this T440. And these disks I found install Windows 7 in German, a language I barely know. And this is Windows 7 Professional, which doesn't let you change the language easily. Anyway, this is Windows 7, which Lenovo still offered on these computers well into the Windows 8 era, and for good reason. It's not quite the same as the OEM copy for the T410. For example, it doesn't have a custom logon screen background. But the Think background is much, much higher resolution. Look at that. So let's explore this installation. The Synaptics driver stopped working because I replaced the trackpad on this T440S with an Alps one. Let's see the system properties. And here it is after calculating the Windows Experience Index. The integrated graphics has the lowest score. So this is standard Windows 7 stuff. Let's see Lenovo Think Manage tools, the typical tools and drivers. And here's an Intel utility about wireless display. It's been discontinued. I wonder why. Intel, why die? Some more Lenovo shortcuts here and the user manual for the T540P and the W540, which are the same generation as the computer I'm trying this software on. It also comes with a trial of Office 2013 instead of Office 2010 Starter. But it requires signing in and setting up an Office 365 trial, which I don't think works anymore. I didn't want to connect to the internet for these installations because most of the software is pretty outdated and likely wouldn't work. I'm sure we're not missing out on much. Here are the Dolby audio settings, which do improve the sound from the speakers a bit. Then we have some Lenovo apps like QuickCast, Quick Control, which even suggests an app for Android and iOS, so let's see if it still exists. And apparently it doesn't. And Lenovo Quick Display, it's asking if you want to send usage information. Here's Norton Internet Security. And this is kind of interesting. The last update was in August 2013, almost 10 years ago. And conveniently, there is an option to uninstall it right there. So how could I resist? Delete all user data and continue. In the meantime, we can look at other stuff, but there's not much. There's the recovery partition with the option to create recovery disks and delete the recovery partition. And here are all the control panel options, like airbag security, which uses the accelerometer to stop the hard drive heads if the computer is being dropped. But I've got a solid state drive in this computer, so I could turn that setting off. The fingerprint settings, which require setting a user account password in Windows. The power manager, which lets you see details about the batteries and set how you want the batteries to be charged, like charge thresholds if you don't want it to be fully charged all the time when plugged in. And here's Lenovo Solution Center, which is complaining about some things, like missing antivirus and no check for driver updates. Because I'm not online, of course. Something about customizing a Lenovo keyboard, which I don't have. The standard Realtek audio settings. Let's restart to see how fast it is. There's the Access Connections app to connect to a network, and the Message Center, which downloads some messages about your computer. No special gadgets. And there are only two custom backgrounds. So as I said before, there isn't an easy way to change the language in Windows 7 Professional or anything other than Ultimate. However, there is a workaround which sometimes works, so let's try it. I must warn you that this workaround to change the language on Windows 7 Professional doesn't always work. I tried it on my other PC with a Windows 7 Pro installation I've had for a longer time, and it was stuck at a black screen with just a mouse cursor. I had to restore from a system image backup. But in this case, it worked, and now I have this OS in English, even though I don't want to take a look at everything again. Now it's time for Windows 8. This one comes in various languages, including English. Let's set it up. And as you can see, there are some telemetry settings, which can be disabled just like on Windows 10. And here's the new way to use Windows. Thank goodness that's no longer the new way. And not a lot of people are gonna disagree that this is kind of a mess compared to 7. Even if you had the touchscreen model of this computer, this is definitely less pleasant to use. Windows 8 still had the Windows Experience Index feature before 8.1, so let's calculate it, and here it is. A little different because it goes up to 9.9 instead of 7.9. Here are the default backgrounds. Not bad. And here I was trying to find the PC info options in the Windows 8 settings app, but I couldn't find it. So let's look at some of the included Windows 8 apps, like AccuWeather. Of course, it can load anything when it's offline. Amazon Kindle, Evernote Touch, Skype, Lenovo Companion, which doesn't seem to show anything besides asking to send info, Norton Studio, a music app called Rara. Look at all those albums. Zinio Reader, SugarSync, Lenovo Settings, which should not be confused with the other settings app. And here there's no option to set charge thresholds. Only fully charge or automatically detect when to stop charging, which in my testing does nothing, so it always charges up to 100%. Dolby Audio settings again, and also Office 2013. Here are most of the same Lenovo tools. And the user guide. Here's the computer window. The recovery partition is hidden here, and the control panel. Oh, and how could I forget? The All Apps section. On Windows 8, you have to right-click on the start screen to get to it. That's not impossible to remember or anything. Here's Norton again, and this one was last updated in May 2013. So this software must have been put together before the Windows 7 one. Here we have the Lenovo Solution Center again. Same thing. And there's Device Manager, not much to see there, and that's pretty much it. Finally, we have Windows 8.1. But don't be fooled, it's still Windows 8, just a little updated. And once again, I could only find it in German. Some kind fellow from Germany uploaded all these recovery disks. So now let's set up Windows 8.1, very similar. Here we have a new background. The Windows Experience Index feature is gone. The PC Settings app is a bit different. And there I could find the option to view the PC info. But unlike Windows 7, which requires Ultimate to change the language officially, Windows 8's language can always be changed, unless you have the Single Language Edition. But it requires connecting to the internet, which I don't want to do on this installation. So here are its Windows 8 apps, Lenovo Companion, nothing, AccuWeather, also nothing, but it's obvious that it needs an internet connection, Norton Studio, Evernote Touch, Xenio, which I believe is an app for reading magazines, Lenovo Support. My computer is out of warranty anyway. TXTR. There's a button there that says try app, but it's grayed out, so we have to move on. Quickcast. Hightail. Never heard of that. Another file sharing app. Lenovo Settings again. More or less the same thing. And also Microsoft Office 2013 again. Here's the all apps list. Here's the computer window, the control panel with all the settings. The Dolby Settings app was updated a bit. In fact, this is also how it looks on Windows 10. Some software included here, which wasn't included on Windows 8.0. It's this janky alternative to the start screen, which is better, but not by much. The Maxthon web browser. I don't know if it still exists or still gets updates. And for some reason, a PC app store, which isn't really necessary since Microsoft implemented one with this Windows version. There's a PDF reader called Nitro Pro with Ribbon user interface. Norton updated the same day as the one we saw on Windows 7. And we see the same settings for a third time. Of course, between Windows 8 and 8.1 there aren't many changes. They updated the bundle software a bit, but most of it is the same. And look at the mess Windows 8.1 leaves behind. I have to close these apps one by one. Needless to say, all three of these variants of OEM software are outdated and unsupported. This T440S is still my main computer running a clean installation of Windows 10 I did in early 2019. It's still working no problem after all the updates. Despite its age, this computer is still super fast at nearly everything I need. So why would I ditch this for a newer computer? I still haven't decided what to do when Windows 10 support ends, since I would like my main PC to have a supported OS, but there's no need to plan that ahead. I'll have to think about it in these 2 years. So there we go, a throwback to software from almost a decade ago. Thank you for watching.